Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to stay updated with KnowledgeHut.
Hello and welcome to KnowledgeHut. In today's video, we will understand what Docker is, how it works, and why it is better than virtual machines. So let us begin. Earlier, there existed some common problems in the software industry before the arrival of Docker. When a developer used to develop an application, it worked fine in its own environment. But when the same application reached production, it wouldn't work properly. This problem occurred due to the difference in the computing environment of dev and product. Another problem was the implementation of microservices. In case you don't know what microservices are, generally large applications are broken down into small services called microservices. They can also be seen as small processes which communicate with each other over a network to fulfill one particular goal. For example, an online shopping service can be broken down into smaller services like account service, product catalog, cart server, and order server. Microservice architecture is popular because it offers some advantages, such as some applications become easier to maintain when they are broken down into smaller services. Whenever required, modifications can be bought in a single service without worrying much about the dependencies of the other services. Another benefit is that when one service goes down, then it does not have a huge impact on the whole application. So before Docker, microservices were deployed using virtualization. Multiple virtual machines were installed on a single host machine. Individual virtual machines used to run individual microservices. The disadvantage of this approach was that it used to cause the wastage of resources as the microservices running in these virtual machines were not using the full potential of the memory, processing power, disk space, etc. of the virtual machines. When there are hundreds of such microservices running, the wastage becomes huge. So how does Docker solve this problem? The implementation of Docker is a little different from virtualization. In the case of Docker, a Linux or Unix-based virtual machine is installed on the host machine. On top of these virtual machines, there are multiple Docker containers which are responsible for running each microservice. The advantage of using containers instead of virtual machine is that unlike a virtual machine, a Docker container does not require you to pre-allocate memory or disk space. The container takes the resources according to the need of the applications. So this is how Docker helps us in optimum utilization of resources. Now let us see how Docker solves our first problem of inconsistent environments. Docker containers wrap a piece of software in the complete file system that contains everything needed to run code, runtime, system tools, system libraries, anything that can be installed on a server. This guarantees that the software will always run the same regardless of its environment. Containers include the application and all of its dependencies. The Docker containers are not tied to any specific infrastructure. They run on any computer, on any infrastructure, and in any cloud. So this was a brief introduction to Docker. Don't forget to subscribe to KnowledgeHut for more such videos.